All right, there we are. I really wish it wouldn't. That mic's not even on. Why is it defaulting to that? Anyway. Are we live? Okay, the feed is live, but that hasn't updated the title or anything. Yeah, we are. Okay, I didn't think that. I wonder what this is actually called. Ah, Resident Evil HD Remaster. Okay, that's what this is called. Well, it's actually not, but whatever. Okay, cool. Right, we're live. Okay, let's do this. What's up, everybody? So, the title of this is pretty self-explanatory. I'm gonna have a go at the knife-only run. Yep, I want original controls because I'm an old man. Yep. We are gonna go on easy because we're using the knife only. And of course, we're gonna play as Jill. Although, you could make a case for Chris being easier because he has way more health. But I mean, you're not really going to be fighting a whole lot of stuff. I would assume you only have to fight the forced fights in the game. So yeah, I've got around to I was checking my achievements on this, and I last played this in June last year before Evo. This was kind of my off game, my on and off game for Evo when I was practicing MK. You know, when I wanted to relax, I just fire up a bit of Resident Evil and play some of this. So let's do this. I haven't played this in a while, but I've played this game a fair amount of times. So hopefully I don't forget too much. Okay, seeing as we're on knife only, I think I'm going to be saving a lot. So let's grab them ink ribbons. I'm not going to watch the cutscenes because this is a serious run for serious people. You know what I mean? You know, we're using the knife only. So right off the bat, I'm assuming you don't really want to kill any zombies that you absolutely don't have to, because they'll come back as claw zombies. And if I recall correctly, you cannot use the oil and the lighter. That counts as a weapon, so we ain't gonna do that. It still surprises me, I don't know why, but man, this game looks bloody good. This game looks really, really good. Even now. So yeah, don't kill any zombies. I'm trying to think, what are the forced fights? You have to fight the claw zombie in the crypt. You have to fight the snake once. What else do you have to fight? The ty you have to fight the tyrant once.
Thanks.
Dog, yeah, you have to kill the dogs to get the key. I'm doing it the wrong way. Is that it? There's not many forced fights. I guess you'd want to kill. You'd ideally want to kill the ceiling hunter before the fuel pump thing. And defense items also count, so I think I just won't bother picking those up. Because there's a lot on easy. You get so many. I remember on the GameCube, I did a run just for fun on easy and like picking up every defense item but never using any. And I think I ended with like 15 or 16 daggers and like a dozen stun guns, which is not far off having a defense item for every single enemy in the game. Right, and I think we're picking up a lot of health, so, which is great because it gives me an excuse to play this game really lame and hoard everything, which is what I like to do. Oh hey, Ekwon. Thanks for stopping by. Yeah, so this is probably gonna be the next run for the next couple of weeks. I need to I'm finished up with the old Tomb Raiders now, so I can get back to the new one. I want to do a I started doing a I tested out like the beginnings of a no upgrade run on the reboot because I know a couple of upgrades are forced, but you can actually put them in slots where they won't affect you at all. there's no one, yeah, there's no one here on easy. So yeah, that's probably gonna be my next run after this. I'm probably gonna do no upgrade run on hard of the reboot. I think that'd be really fun. Cause that game's pretty tough on hard. You're not all that survivable. And I'd forgot that in the reboot, you actually don't have health. You only have healing. Whereas in Rise, you know, they actually put in the ability to heal. Man, playing this gets me so excited for the RE2 remake. I really can't wait for that. And right after this, I've got Zero to play too, because this is the Xbox One version. I got that the double pack where you get this and the remake of Zero. Because I love these games. Okay, so I'm remembering most of it. Say so I played this relatively recently. I remember there's a way to really speed up the stair animation. I think it's just like hammer. Is it like hammer run as you go up the stairs or something? I really hope they put the 3D examining in the RE2 remake. I remember when I played RE2 for the first time, I was really disappointed that they took away the ability to, you know, look at stuff like this and spin it around and that. That was such a cool thing about the original Resident Evil. Like every time you picked up a gun, you could always, you know, check it out and see how it looked. Yeah, is it? That doesn't seem that much quicker. Like, is there a pattern to that? Is there like a rhythm? Something. Hey, what's up, Faye? How you been, man? How have you been this past few weeks? I mean, Faye, I'm glad you stopped by. You reminded me. I need to check Titanfall because that was on sale on Origin. Titanfall 2, so I need to play Titanfall 2. Hear very good things about that. Hang on, let me think. Sword key, sword key, sword key. Yep, it's this way. But I've got too many items, so I'm gonna go need to offload some shit. There is always one sword key that I always forget where it is. I always end up still having that key, and you should obviously get rid of all of them. Been busy with work lately, man. I can relate to that, Faye. Work has been crazy since the new year for me as well. I've been so busy. I mean, I started playing Dishonored in the holiday, and I thought, yeah, I'll chip away at that over the next few weeks. I have not had the time to play that since going back to work because I've been so busy. Right, let's combine these because that will give me a full heal. Man, there's a lot of items here. Tried to get into Gears of War 4. How are you finding Gears 4, Faye? I wasn't really bothered about the multiplayer in that, but really enjoyed the campaign. There we go. So I can come back to this if I need it. Come back to these hell. But it's full of assholes and douchebags. Yeah, that's Gears for you. Unfortunately, that is Gears of War. It's not very welcoming to new people. But I was kind of disappointed in the multiplayer of that. Played it and was like, yep, you know, this is exactly how it was in the beta. And the beta was basically Gears 3, which I've played a hell of a lot of. So I didn't really want to, you know, get into it much past that. I mean, I think it's still good, like in terms of, you know, mechanics, like a multiplayer shooter, it's still really good, but I need a few years away from, oh crap, I need a few years away from Gears, I think, to kind of get the urge to play it again. I feel like I need to do to Gears what I kind of did with Halo, like take a really long break from it and then go back to it. Right, okay, we've got loads of ink ribbons. I am gonna be weird and organize my case because, you know, I like doing that. Right, I'll always keep one health item with me. There's no point keeping the knife if I don't actually have to fight anything. Because the only thing I have to fight is that claw zombie. So, yeah. Campaign's okay, but kind of mediocre. I would agree with that about 3. But I really liked the ending in 4. I really thought the ending set up, you know, some pretty interesting questions. Aha. I forgot, yeah. It's kind of like RE4. Like, yeah, I have to, like, nudge forward and then get them. Oh, no, wait. I've got to fight the dog. I do need the knife. All right. Let's go grab the dog whistle, get my knife back. Yeah, pretty much. It's very much like, the easiest parallel, I think, for Gears multiplayer is, like Halo 3 MLG settings in a lot of ways. Like, it's a one-gun game, apart from power weapons. It's all about the shotgun. It's all about the shotgun, but the power, you know, you gotta control the power weapons. I didn't really play it enough to see if the rifles were good. Like, the rifles were really effective in 3. I think they did do a good job of actually making the rifles, you know, a good alternative. Depending on the map, you could very well keep your rifle and pick up a power weapon. Whereas in Gears 1 and 2, you virtually never wanted to do that. Come on. Hang on, if I get him on the stairs, he'll just spit acid, won't he? Yeah. In a bit. Has there been any DLC for Gears Fair? I was wondering. Because I noticed the double shotty wasn't in there. They had that, like, new... How was it called? Was it called the... What was that, like... The electro shotgun thing called? Was it the jackhammer? That was really fun. I really liked that. That was a really fun weapon. It's fun to just get the active on the bigs and then just dump on them with that gun. Oops. That's a bit too much. A bit too much RE4. Okay, we'll get him to the stairs. Come on. There we go. Get past him. Oh, yeah, I agree with that. Yeah. It reminded me a lot of Halo 2, actually, the way that ends. I thought the last boss was the kind of second to last boss, and then, you know, when you beat it and you realize it's over, you're like, oh, okay. I thought there was going to be more. I thought there was going to be more than that, and there isn't, which was a shame, because the last boss is kind of boring. Right, yep, going the right way. This is a very rambling, friendly game. I can just walk around and talk to myself. And you fail, obviously. Don't pick that up. Yeah, so there's really no point picking up defense items, because all that's going to do is accidentally fuck you up if you get touched. And there's so much health on this mode. But that said, you know, you are going to want to try and stockpile as much of that health as possible. I imagine the first claw zombie is going to take quite a bit. I can't imagine the snake's going to be, you know, easy. Right, I've never done this, so this is my disclaimer. This is my first time trying to beat this game with the knife, so. Get off me. Ow. What? Alright. How's my health doing? I'm okay. What? Yeah, I'm okay. Yeah, take that. That was pretty easy. Like that, what was that? I think that was that 4 or 5 hits on him? Right, so we'll make use of these herbs while they're still there. And then, yeah, let's go get the armor key. I think there's only 1 or 2 actual mandatory sword key doors. There's not many. There's a new map tied to the season pass. Oh, great stuff. That's what put me off Horde mode as well, Faya. I was kind of, you know, I knew I wasn't really going to play the multiplayer all that much. And with Horde mode, you know, I thought, oh, I'll try Horde mode. And just as soon as someone dies, they quit. Like, I don't think I ever got up to, like, wave further than wave 6 without someone leaving. And then once someone leaves, everyone else leaves, and you're just there on your own. It's like, great. You know, that sucked. But I think Horde mode Horde mode felt a little bit token in 4. Like, you know, it just felt like they were like, oh, you know, we've got to have a Horde mode. Like, you know, it's got to be there. I'm going the long way around, aren't I? Yeah, they didn't really do much with it. I think Horde mode by far was the best in 3. I think Horde mode in 3 was easily the best. And it just felt like, you know, it was expected to be there. I would have preferred if they'd kind of gone all out on a beast mode system. Because I thought beast mode was really good. And with the robots and that, you'd have a bit more variety. Alright, this guy's just going to stand there. Cue zombie in 3, 2, 1. Bye-bye. That's a great noise. But if you want to help me with the Insane Co-op campaign, let me know. Ooh, I might take you up on that, Faya, because I started that campaign on Insane. But I just got fed up of it, because it, like, solo, it's completely busted. Like, it's so broken. So, yeah, I'd be up for that. I'll drop you a message on Xbox Live, and we'll try and set something up. Because I really did like the campaign. I thought the campaign was good. No, not that. If it's like a pressure thing, wouldn't you just be able to like put your foot on it? Then again, no one would really help you, would it? Because you'd still have to move off. Man, forgot how quick this game is when you know where to go. I'm what, like about 15 minutes into this and already have the armor key. I was always tempted to have a go at speedrunning Resident Evils. They're the one kind of game that I would enjoy doing. It's more about kind of root, you know, the root optimization as opposed to like, you know, tricky mechanics. Okay, yeah, we're going to the. Ah, you missed. I forgot to unlock that door, didn't I? No! Get off me. They attack the other zombies, don't they? Yeah, I could have swore they could damage the other zombies. Thought they would have. By the way, how come you played so much Tomb Raider lately? The reason for that was because I really wanted to play Rise when it came out. I was really like that was a huge release for me. I was really looking forward to that, but I didn't want to play it on Xbox One. I wanted to wait for the PC version, and I think that came out. I think it was Xbox One. PC then PS4, or the other way around, but I didn't get around to playing it until this past holiday because I didn't have the time until then. Hang on, where am I going? Nope, I'm going the wrong way again. God damn it. So yeah, and I played through Rise and really, really didn't enjoy it. I was really disappointed in Rise of the Tomb Raider. That felt more like a really bad Uncharted clone than it did a follow-up to the reboot. And it really made me curious. I thought, was the reboot actually that good? You know, like, because I really, really enjoyed the reboot, like, a lot. And I might have even been doing the Mighty Electronic Box podcast when I did that. Maybe. I can't remember. But I really, really enjoyed the reboot. And I just kind of thought to myself, was the reboot actually that good? And it really made me want to go back to it. So I went back and played the reboot, and the reboot is that good. It's amazing. And it just made me curious to go back to old Tomb Raiders. The last, you know, I stopped playing those on the PS1 because they just got kind of stale, you know, that they really got very kind of formulaic and predictable. And I thought I didn't really play any of the last gen ones, so I wanted to play through Legend and Underworld. And I played through those over the past couple of weeks, and they hold up better than I would have thought they would. And just really made me want that kind of Tomb Raider game again. You know, like, the reboot was really good, I really did like it, but you spend a lot of time shooting at people in the reboot, you know? In the older games, it was more about the tombs and kind of, you know, more mysterious enemies, you know? And I always felt that was a bit more enjoyable, a bit more entertaining. And the reboot, while good, like, you know, you shoot a lot of guys in the face with machine guns. Or a bow and arrow, if you meet. I like the bow and arrow. But yeah, it would be nice for them to go back to that a little bit. I still have half a mind to play Angel of Darkness, because apparently that's just a huge mess of a game, and I'm curious, like, you know, what makes it so bad. So I do have half a mind to go and play that. Yeah, the story was terrible in Rise. That was one of the main things that, kind of the main thing that made me didn't like it. I thought the story was really bad. Not only was it bad, but it was poorly told. Just real cardboard cutout characters, super, super typical. And I thought Lara's performance was really bad in Rise. And again, after going back and playing through the reboot again, you know, her performance in the reboot is actually pretty damn good. It's a pretty amazing, like, voiceover and performance capture. And in the reboot, it just really sounds like she's phoning it in, and it really took me out of that game. Right, we've got Death Mask, Armor Key. Oh yeah, Armor Keys. Oh, Richard, that's where we're going. I forgot, Richard. Yeah, the tombs as well, man. The tombs in Legend and Underworld. I mean, God, they put the entire environments in even the new games to shame. They're so big. They're enormous. And, you know, the focus of those games is the tombs, you know? The focus of the new games is the shooting. You know, they are third-person shooters, you know, with some Tomb Raider sprinkled on top. Whereas the Tomb Raider games are more about exploration and puzzles with some action sprinkled on top. You know, they kind of flip the table on that completely. Yeah, I completely forgot. I need to go save Richard. What am I doing? Pissing about. The only door left to unlock is the one that I don't actually need to go in. So, but yeah, I'll probably still give the next Tomb Raider a look, but I really hope they rein in the unchartedness of Rise. And I think I remember after reading up on it, I remember reading a quote from, I think it was Phil Spencer, about it basically regarding Rise's Xbox One exclusivity, and I can't remember what he said exactly. I'm going to look it up real quick if I can, because I don't want to misquote. But I remember reading that quote and thinking, yeah, that, you know, it makes sense that Rise turned out the way it did, going by, you know, what you just said. Let me see if I can find that. Type in Rise. It's the fourth result. It's still under Rise of the Planet of the Apes. I wonder what that means. Yeah, let's have a look at that. What did he say? So yeah, there's even DLC for Rise, which I got the the Super Duper Edition, whatever it's called, and I actually have that, but I just don't want to play it. I just really don't want to play the game. Ah, yeah, here we are. Speaking on the exclusivity, Phil Spencer said, "I'm a big fan of Uncharted, and I wish we had an action-adventure game of that ilk. We've started some, and we've looked at them, but we don't have one today of that quality. This is an opportunity." That really kind of sums up why Rise of the Tomb Raider feels like a kind of not budget Uncharted game, but it feels like it's really trying to riff on Uncharted more than it is trying to build on the 2013 reboot, which is what just really stuck out to me the entire time. Like, that game starts off with a, like, super scripted platforming segment that has, you know, that has no real consequence. You know, it's all super scripted and, like, on rails, shitty platforming. The reboot starts out with you just trying to survive and get through that initial area and get to camp and feed yourself. Like, they are so different in their openings. And, you know, you really feel like the... As I said, I mentioned it in the blog post a lot. Like, the reboot just felt a lot more confident. It felt like it really knew what it wanted to do. Whoops, I hit my mic there with my mug. Sorry about that. The story DLC is meh, but has some new effects. Yeah, that's kind of what I was worried about. That reminds me, I've got all the DLC for Shadow of Mordor too, but kind of fell off that game as well. That game, man. That should have been... I think they should have gone a bit further with that. I don't think they should have... It deserved... Like, the game they had... The game that is in there deserves more than just, like, to be a Batman clone, you know? There is a way better game in Shadow of Mordor than what's actually there. Oh no, I need the lighter, don't I? I got that Chris achievement earlier today for where you have to save Chris as Rebecca. And I guess I got used to having the lighter. There are two zombie DLCs. Oh man. I love zombies, alright. Don't get me wrong. I really love me some zombie. I love Resident Evil. I love Dead Rising. Left 4 Dead. I love me some zombie. But even I'm kind of sick of zombies right now. Oh god, I can't remember this one. Is it this one first and then the other two? Oh, good start. Yeah, and then it's this one, isn't it? I am surprised the zombie train is still going, to be honest. Feels like it's kind of started with like Call of Duty, and it just kind of keeps going. The survival DLC in co-op. No, I didn't know it had co-op. Right, so that's my second death mask. I suppose, really, if you're going to do, like, this is almost like a speed run in a way, because you're not really going to be killing much, are you? Right, there's still guys out here. Wait, there we go. I need to go drop off some items. Ah, you missed. Man, I really can't wait for that Resi 2 remake. So, I don't know, I'm just so excited for it, even though it's like, there's like nothing out about it yet. I really am looking forward to that. I don't need that anymore. I don't need that until I fight the claw zombie. So yeah, I should just stockpile health, really. This is kind of the perfect run for me. I get to hoard everything. I do kind of want to get this out of the way, though, because I want to do this. I've got this and the no save run to do. The no save run will be piece of cake, because I can just load a... I can load a save with, you know, the infinite weapons and blast through that. And then I really need to crack on with the remake of Zero. I haven't played that in ages. I haven't played Zero since that came out on the Wii. The GameCube. It did come out on the Wii, but that's not where I played it. I played it on the GameCube. Aha. You have to survive in a large forest, hunt animals for food, and find fireplaces for heat, fight enemies and raid tombs filled with traps. Huh. Is there any kind of end game, or is it just, like, survive as long as you can kind of deal? Lighter. What am I doing? I haven't got any health, have I? That's not good. I love how they changed the readout system in this to like a paper thing scrolling that's actually animated. Like that's so cool. Have you tried RE7, by the way, Faya? I wonder if you've played that. I've been getting a lot of buzz, but I just can't get into it. I've got the demo downloaded. I actually downloaded the demo. Because I had half a mind to just get it and just find out. I don't really want to dump 45 quid on that and, you know, have it have it basically be what I think it is, which is, you know, another shitty first-person survival game. Ah, oh, damn it! I think I know Icy was on sale on Steam. I can't remember if that's still on sale. I wanted to get that. It's like looks like a really cool 2D action game. You can call a heli for extraction. Oh, that's cool. Come on, man. Well, that worked, I guess. What did you think of the upgrades in that? In Rise, just reminded me about that fair. One of my really big issues with that was, I mean, I played through that on hard, on my first go, because I mean, they're pretty easy. And I remember upgrades just feeling like completely unnecessary. Like I think I got to about halfway through the game before I upgraded anything, and I didn't really need to upgrade stuff. It was just, well, you know. These upgrade points are burning a hole in my kind of virtual pocket, so I guess I should just spend them. Like, I really felt like it didn't make the upgrades feel necessary at all. And as I said, like, you know, I was playing it on hard. I couldn't understand if I was playing it on easy or something, but I thought if I'm playing it on hard and your upgrades feel really pointless, then, you know, you kind of messed up somewhere. Played the demo, but it didn't quite grab me. Oh, fair enough. Yeah, I should try. I should play the demo. I should at least give it a go. Because I'm curious. You know, all the positivity surrounding that. It's just got me really curious. You know, I think is it actually good? Like, you know, have they actually pulled it off? Have they made a decent game? But I don't know. Maybe. I think they should have just left it alone. But I suppose Resident Evil, you know, it's still a big name. For better or for worse, it is still a big name. Alright, so we've got to go do the piano, which will be death mask number 3, and then we'll do the pictures with the, and then we'll do the room with the pictures, which is the 4th one, and then it's off to the guardhouse. Oh no, the next one is, what's his face? The snake. But I don't have to fight him yet. I should probably save. I'll definitely save before the claw zombie. Oh man, for a split second there, I thought I didn't have the key. I thought that was... Wait, this is an armor key door, really? Oh yeah, it is. I thought that was... Because in the original, in like the PS1 Resident Evil, that's a sword key door. But with Jill, she can just unlock it with the lockpick. The sword key. You only get the sword key with Chris in the original, I think. Don't quote me on that. Has been a few years. There is even a hardcore survival in Rise of the Tomb Raider now where you get thrown back to your last fire camp if you die. That seems... That doesn't really seem that bad. Like, as I said, like, you know, you can... Oh shit, I forgot the emblem. God damn it. I'm such an idiot. Yeah, it was mainly the combat. You know, I thought the combat was just so easy. Like, you missed. Oh yeah, you probably will, but I mean, like, I didn't go right. I went like, you know, one down from the hardest one, and you know, it was still a very, very easy game. And that kind of killed the exploration stuff, you know, because I thought, well, if I'm not using, you know, the only stuff to get from exploring is upgrades. And I thought, well, I don't need them, so I'm not going to do these tombs. So it kind of a bit of a spiral effect. Come on, lunge at me. There we go. There's probably a way to get them to do that, like, super consistently, but... Oh, crap, I just thought, you have to fight... You're going to have to fight, what's her face, aren't you? Lisa Trevor. I think the reboot definitely suffered from that a little bit, though. Like, you don't really need many of the upgrades in the reboot, but... But I really hope they expand the tombs for the next one. I think the tombs are still like a real, like they take a real back seat to the game. As I said, like it's a third person shooter with optional tombs. I really think they should bring more of the tomb raiding to the forefront and have that be, you know, some of the objectives. If I remember rightly, I think he, like, Uncharted does that more than Rise did. Like, there's a lot of, like, you know, puzzle stuff in that in Uncharted that, you know, is part of the main game. Granted, they're not very hard, but didn't like the score attack mode. I don't think, yeah, I can't imagine those mechanics lending themselves to score attack, really. They're very, you know, they try to be more grounded mechanics as opposed to kind of, you know, more twitchy. I remember when I first played this, when it came out, I couldn't remember what this was, and I thought it was really complicated, but you just have to back out when it's completed, whereas usually, like, when you complete a puzzle, that's it. It does it for you. It took me ages to remember that. Alright, let's go. Nah, I don't think of the whole points system either. Yeah, I'm going the right way. I really need to get back to NG at some point too. I need to do that bloody single segment run again. But like, just it's annoying finding the time to set aside that, to set aside for that rather. Like in the holiday, it was easy, you know. It was easy to just sit down, like, plan that stuff out. But right, let's do this. You know, let's just get this speed run out of the way. So I'm really curious what kind of single segment time I can get now that I actually have a route. Like, that route on the segmented run, I feel is pretty damn accurate. Like, it's pretty optimal. And I'd be interested to see how that works, applying that to... Ow, you bastard! Single segment. Alright, I need to get back to the... Oh, shit. I'm on caution as well. I'm out. Peace, Richard. Got a new headset. which one did you get? Do you mean for your Xbox Fair, or...
No!
Do I get... No, I don't get teleported back. Yeah, do you mean for your Xbox or PC? Because I got a new mic for streaming. I actually got a studio mic. And it's annoying. Like, it's too good. It's too good to stream with. Like, I have a lot of stuff, like, on my setup. Like, and there's just... It picks up the little bits of interference. Like, in after processing, it's amazing. Like, it's what I'll be using for voiceovers and stuff, for sure. And eventually the podcast, if we ever start the podcast again regularly. But in terms of streaming, like, you know, without being able to filter out that interference on the fly, which I don't know how to do, and B, I don't know if it's possible to actually do that. It's just too bloody sensitive, which is annoying because it's a really nice mic. And it looks cool too. Got it in my favorite color. But this one's still serving me well, this good old Microsoft USB headset. I am not sponsored by Microsoft. Just putting that out there. It would be cool to be though. But yeah, this one, I've had this. Man, I need to go back. I'll have to check my videos. Go back to when my commentary actually started sounding good and not like total shit. Because I was doing some server sorting a few weeks ago. It was in the holiday, actually. And I looked at one of the older videos where I was using just the 3.5mm jack headset. And God, it sounded like shit. Right, we've got loads of ink ribbons. Okay, so yeah, it's claw zombie time. So I really don't know how much health he's gonna take off me. It's probably gonna be a lot. Because he's got, like, some good grabs, too. Wanted either an Astro 58, wanted an Astro A50 Gen 3 or a Steel Series 840. Wow, 300, you fucking hell, man. What am I doing? I'm going the wrong way again. Well, I'm not going the wrong way, but... I've heard good things about Turtle Beach headsets. Whoa, get off me. Bitch. Alright, we're okay. For Xbox One. Yeah, man, that's a lot to spend. Like, I'm still using my old pads for Xbox One. I haven't bought a new Xbox One. I'm using a PS4 pad right now because, like, you know, just Resident Evil feels right on a PlayStation pad, you know. Doesn't feel right on a 360 pad. Just, or an Xbox pad. Like, just, I like the PS4 pad for Resident. I like the PS4 pad. It's a really good pad. And that converter saved me having to buy a new Xbox One controller. So, and I can use whatever controller I want. I can use my 360, my PS4, PS3. I can use any arcade stick on it. So, like, the downside of not being able to use a mic, I think, is worth it. What? Open this door. Yeah, wireless sounds good, though. Wireless sounds nice. Let's get rid of this key. Oh, I thought that was the last armor key door. Oh no, is it the room? Is it the forest room? Oh, I will grab that though. That's a first aid spray right there. And then first aid sprays. Red and green. I'm sure someone's got a rhyme somewhere for red and green, giving you full health. I can't think of one off the top of my head. As I'm not gifted like that. So we're at 40 minutes. Cool, we're making good progress. 40 minutes and we're almost at the guardhouse. Well, good, mate. Right, so... go away. I should have picked that up, actually. I need to look into building, like, a custom mic mute switch, too. Because there's no built-in mute switch on that... studio mic. That probably should be enough, but we'll take one more. I can't imagine he's gonna take that much off me. That's like four heals and all that health as well, so should be alright. I was gonna try and do this in one go. Alright, so what can I save over? Because this is a weird system, this game. Like, your clear data is tied to the saves. I won't need that anymore, so let's do that one. I think it's color-coded too, isn't it? Like, red's hard, I think green's normal, is blue easy, and then pink is very easy. The orange one is invisible enemy mode, which is kind of fun. Almost ended up building my own headset with a Bluetooth headphone and a boom mic from... I would have been really interested to see that process, like building a headset. That'd be cool. Alright, oh, you... shit. You piece of shit. Right, oh, bollocks. I need all... oh, crap. Yeah, I can't take this much health in because I need the death masks. That's the last armor key door, you imbecile. God, I'm so stupid. See, this is why I'm not a speed... this is why I don't do many speedruns. The memory's not great. Get off me. Right, I'll pick that up now. I'm still on fine. That's surprising. But yeah, this is why I don't do many speedruns. I'm forgetful. And this is definitely why I wouldn't really stream speedruns either. I might as well put three in, if I put three in and then go back and save and then get the last one and go and fight him, and then I can take loads of health. I should really pay attention to where he is. Yeah, now I'm on caution. Is that the last time I can go through there? I think it might be. Wait, that was the last door. Now, I should remember this puzzle, as I did it, like, this week. But it's yeah, the bracelet needs to be okay, yeah, so, no, that's wrong. Because I can't remember if the order matters, or you just have to have them all the correct color before you press the final switch. Yeah, there we are. This one I know is definitely this side. It's more like a setup. Bluetooth headphones have 3.5mm jack where you can plug in the boom mic from V mode. Oh, okay. And is this one on this side? Yeah, that's right, isn't it? The crown is green, bracelet is orange, necklace is purple. Wait, yeah, because in the original, it was the order that you press the switches. I really want to have a go at this guy, but I really don't think that's going to be enough health. I'm thinking, like, a dog took a full heal off me, and I was able to kill the dog in 5 hits. Like, I think this guy is going to take considerably more than 5 hits. Is that the one that's in here? I really like that they put this stuff in too. Having to examine items. Like, I thought that was really cool. That wasn't really in the previous ones. It'd be cooler to bring that back. For game audio, I have Turtle Beach. Yes, I'm playing. So virtual stereo, so. Ah, very nice. Very nice. I very rarely use headphones when I game. I really should, because like the few times I have used headphones, it's amazing. Like Dead Space with headphones is so much different to Dead Space with no headphones. Yeah, let's go save. Let's be a pansy about it. I think like this game is another one. Like I remember I played through this once with headphones on. This was back in like when I had it on the GameCube, and like I just plugged the headphones into my TV, and man, it's such a difference to playing with it. Like playing these kind of games with headphones versus no headphones is just, it's like two different games almost. Sound really matters. I think this is the last time I can go through this door though. So I'm gonna have to come back the long way around. Right, where is this fucker? Take that. Right, let's go. Okay. That's gotta be enough. Watch him die in like 6 hits or something daft. Yeah, that one. Ah, what's this called in the original? Is it? I think it's just storeroom. Is it like Mansion S storeroom? I think is the name of this save point in RE1. It's like the perfect save. It's like the perfect location for a save room. It's like kind of smack bang in the middle of the mansion. Oh. No. Lunge at me, you dick. There we go. Right. We've got to go back. We've got to go back the long way. Oh, come on. That was bullshit. Well. Would it be worth going to those herbs? It probably would be as, like, I want to be able to take at least two hits from the claw zombie before I heal. Ah, whatever, let's try it. I've got five heals, so I should be able to take one hit and then be okay. Well, be okay to heal. I don't think he can one-shot me at caution. Thank God you don't have to fight any hunters, man. Imagine fighting hunters with the knife. Would suck. Yeah. I've got four heals. Right, yeah. So I've got five full healths, essentially. Because if he gets me down to low health, and then I kill him, it doesn't matter. I can just go heal again. And there's some herbs left where the... what's it called? There's some herbs left where I got the chemical. So I've got some to get. And there's quite a lot of health in the guardhouse. That's a good spot for health. Okay. I'm just gonna try a few things. Can you use this coffin to like? Oh, you can't actually go around the coffin. Oh, that's annoying. There's, I'm just thinking there's got to be an angle where you can, like... Ah, no! Yeah, that's... Does attacking, like... Does where you attack him make a difference? Seems like you are going to have to, like, trade hits with him. Whoa! Can you knock him over? Oh, that didn't hit me. Oh, you bitch. It's annoying how that's the most, like, reliable way to get a hit on him. Yeah, like, you can't really do that. Oh. Does that do less damage than the claw? How many hits is that? Like, about 10? Fuck off. Alright, I got no health. Take that. Ow. Oh, shit. Oh, is he dead? Yeah, get wrecked. Yeah, I would have been fucked with I would have been fucked with 3 health items. I would have died, for sure. What's the point of the CQC achievement? It's complete the entire game only using the knife. That's the achievement. And you don't get many points for it. I think it's 30? It's 30 or 40. It's not a lot. Whereas you, for completing the game on invisible enemy mode, which you can do on any difficulty, you get 100. And I really think they should have been flipped. Like, invisible enemy mode really isn't hard. Like, you can just like do what everybody does basically, put it on easy and just go and do like a pseudo speed run and you're fine. I think this one's way harder. Because you actually have to fight, you know, enemies. Ah, you missed. Yeah, that's all I need. Right. Let's go to the guardhouse. What time we got? We got a bit more time. It's probably going to be about an hour stream. It's funny. We recorded an episode of HMK earlier. And it was by far the most efficient episode ever. But we started like half an hour late, so I lost like half an hour of stream time. It was kind of a pain in the ass. Fortunately, this is pretty quick though. Like, this game isn't very long. Right, so yeah, we need to go over here, get walloped by Lisa Trevor. I want to keep that. I can't remember. Is it north and west, or is it west and north? Yeah, west and north, I think. Oh, I remember. Yeah, you actually want them in this. You want them on the same point, but not the same actual direction as they're orientated. I really hope we see something about RE2 soon. I really do. Just an idea of like kind of how far along that game is. Like, should we expect it this year? Next year, the year after that. Like, I hope we don't have to wait that long. Like, I could easily deal with it being next year. If it was the year after, I'd be a bit sad about that. And probably stick with PC too. Like, that was a really weird thing. I put my PS4 in storage this week. I couldn't believe that. But it had been for like 4 or 5 months since I used it, and I thought like this is just gathering dust. Like, this isn't doing anything. You never play it. I mean, I only have the Xbox One out for Halo. I have the 360 out for NG. Like, if those games were playable on PC, you know, the Xbox One would have gone away a long time ago. As is, you know. Sometimes all you need is one great game to keep a system, you know, on the shelf. Sometimes all you need is just that one game. Right, so how's my healing items looking? He took quite a lot off me. Although I have still got quite a lot left in the mansion. It's not like I'm out of health. Funny how this doesn't take any health off you. Bonk. She conks you right on the head. How do you end up down there? Like, how does that happen? RE2 was 1998. So next year would be oh, you bastard. She's annoyingly hard to dodge. Yeah, so next year would be 20 years. That makes sense. 20 years. I've been I haven't played Halo much in the past few weeks. I'm so glad I put an expansion hard drive though on my Xbox, cuz I mean I was out of space after like 3 games, which is a ridiculous, but at least now, you know, I don't have to worry about installing stuff. But yeah, I could see it as a 20 year anniversary thing. I got to admit, part of me really can't believe it's been that long since RE2 came out. 20 years. I still remember playing the demo. I remember the cover of the magazine that I got my demo disc in. It had like RE2 written in the middle. It was a white cover, RE2 written in the middle. I think it was PSM2. And no, not PSM2, sorry, PSM. Because it would have just been PSM back then. And it had RE2 written on it in blood, like, you know, like bloody finger smears, and it just was surrounded by hands, like zombie hands. That was the cover of the magazine that had the demo for RE2 in it. I really wish I hadn't gotten rid of those. I can't remember when I would have done it. Like, maybe to, like, make some room or something one year. Like, you know, just, you know, have a, you know, when you have those, like, kind of sort outs and you get rid of stuff. I would have got rid of, like, all my magazines, all my demo discs, and God, I really wish I hadn't have done that. Right, let's grab these. I played Halo 5 earlier today, but it was so laggy, it was really annoying. And, like, usually it's really solid online, so. But, I mean, kind of in the mood for something new regarding shooters. Like, I think I've kind of, like, I've really had my fill on Halo. Like, you know, I've played a lot of Halo 5 over the past year. I've played a shitload of that game. But I kind of feel, you know, satiated on Halo now until Halo 6. So, you know, it'd be nice to get into something a bit new, which is why Titanfall sounds intriguing. And pick up Titanfall 2, get into that maybe. Or if anyone's still playing Killzone 2, maybe. Because I got my splitter in this week, and I can record my PS3 through HDMI. So, and I've got Killzone 2 on the backlog. That's definitely going to get played through soon. Really interested to see how that game has aged. Because that game blew my socks off when I played through that. For my money as well, I think it still had one of the best multiplayers ever. Killzone 2's multiplayer was so good. Can't imagine there's anyone left playing it, though. I don't remember the campaign being all that great. Like, my fondness for Killzone 2 was definitely, like, that first month where its multiplayer was just really, really popular and thriving. So good. I always heard that they patched it to play like Killzone 3. I never actually knew if that was true. I would really hope it isn't, because even though I did like Killzone 3, but is Titanfall 2 not crossplay fair on Xbox One and PC? I was kind of hoping it was, because I'd prefer to play that on PC, as I now have my new lovely 1070. But, I mean, I could play it on Xbox One. I'd rather have someone to play with than play a nicer-looking version but have to deal with people. Yeah, I really can't remember the campaign all that well. I don't remember the campaign being very good, as I said. Like, a lot of my praise for that game was its multiplayer. Its multiplayer was fantastic. And just so underappreciated, because nobody had PS3s when it came out. I say nobody, but, like, very few people had PS3s when that game came out. That was, Killzone 2 was 2009, if I remember rightly. And I don't, like, the PS3 didn't really hit its stride until like 2010, I think. Like, that's when the PS3 was kind of... That's when it was kind of at punching weight with the 360, I feel. Like, the PS3, you know, it took a long time for that to get going. But funnily enough, it's one of the few consoles I have hooked up, because I've got Deadly Premonition to play through. I got the director's cut. And I remember I played through the beginning. I played through, like, the... basically, what is the tutorial level. And I really want to try and find a way to stream that, because I haven't played through that in a long time. And the PS3 version has a lot of extra content in it, but it's such a big game. And, you know, with my stream schedule, even if I did it once a week, that game could very well take a year to play through, playing it once a week. Like, it's an enormous game. I think my first playthrough was like 40 hours. And I haven't played it, you know, and I can't really remember where to go and that in it, so. I remember Killzone 3 having a really good campaign, though. Funnily enough, I actually have Shadowfall for PS4, but my PS4's in the cupboard, so. You bastard. Has that poisoned me? In terms of creepy spiders, I really don't think you can beat those, can you? They are creepy as shit. I should really probably play Shadowfall. But that means having to set the PS4 back up. And I'm pretty much out of space on it too, I think. I think I'm like under 100 gigs on my PS4, which is crazy because I only have 5 PS4 games. Right, what time are we on? Just over an hour? Yeah, I'm going to have to call it there because I need to get my stuff ready for tomorrow as it's back to work. Right, we've got 18 ink ribbons. We're swimming in ink ribbons. That'd be really messy. Open it. That's what we got here. Green and blue. Okay, so that gives me a poison heal. I mean, Deadly Premonition is not a great game. But it also is kind of a great game. Deadly Premonition's a weird one. I feel like to really enjoy Deadly Premonition, you've got to have... I mean, even for me, like, you know, I've always been a mechanics guy first and foremost, but you've got to be able to appreciate what that game does aside from its, you know, core mechanics in order to really appreciate that. If you want to play a game and just have a really good gaming experience, Deadly Premonition is not the game to play, you know. But if you want to play a game and have a very, like, I don't know, emotional experience, because it's funny, it's sad in some ways, it's also really frustrating, and the mechanics really piss you off. Like, that game manages to get every emotion out of you possible, I think, and I think that's why it's worth playing. But, you know that you're not going to have an amazing gameplay experience while you play it, but I wouldn't hesitate to recommend Deadly Premonition to somebody. But anyway, on that note, that is going to do it for this stream, guys. I'm hoping to maybe get this done in the week, because I can do this in, like, short segments, but we'll have to see. We'll have to see. My bike test is coming up, so I need to get prepared for that. So, hope you guys enjoyed the stream, and if you're watching on YouTube, I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will catch you guys in the next one. Peace. Take care.